Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us see the influences of language designing, guys. So basically, the basic design of programming language influence many factors, guys. So there are two designs in which the computers are designed. Those are nothing but according to their architecture neutral, or according to their architecture, and they are also depending on programming methodologies, guys. So we'll be discussing among these two in this tutorial. Okay. So basically, computer architecture. So well-known concept of computer architecture is von Neumann architecture. So the language which are designed according to von Neumann architecture are called as imperative languages, guys. Most of the languages we call as imperative languages, right? So those all belongs to von Neumann architecture, one of the most popular architecture model. So in von Neumann architecture, same memory area is shared between the data and the program. So there will be a common area for both storing both program and data. So the CPU has function. The CPU whose function is to execute the instructions is separated from the memory. Fine. So similarly, if you draw a block diagram for that, you'll be having the input on one side, the output on the one side, and memory will be on the lower side. And you'll be having a CPU which has control unit and it can perform the arithmetic and logic unit. So now everyone got a small idea on this. So further moving on, what are the advantages? So data from memory and from device are accessed in the same way. Yeah, that's an advantage, guys. And the program can be stored in a smaller size. Yeah, that's also an advantage. Easy memory organization. So the memory organization will be really, really easy, guys. So, and the disadvantages of are confusion between the data and instructions. So as the data and instructions are stored in the same memory location, there will be many, many confusion, guys, due to that issue. So further moving on, disadvantages are confusing. Okay, we are done with that. And only handles one task at a time, guys. As both are in the same location, they can only do one task at a time. Okay, guys, I'll be changing the camera angle as we are getting shadow. Okay, fine. I'm changing that soon. So instructions stored in the same memory as data can be accidentally rewritten by an error in a program. Yeah, this is one of the most important aspects, guys, because we are not the pro programmers who can just program without a single error. So if there is an error, we can just replace the whole main source of the von Neumann architecture or any kind of programming language. So in late 1960s and early 1970s, guys, the programming methodologies came into play. Fine, we'll be going through them in detail, don't worry. So I'll be just giving an introduction in this tutorial. So programming methodologies in late 1960s and 1970s, several programming methodologies came into existence in order to overcome the deficiency and to enhance the futures of programming language, to increase their abilities. So these all came into play, guys. So in 1970s, new programming languages came into existence, like procedure oriented programming language, which is a top two. Excuse me, guys, sorry for that. Okay, procedure oriented programming language, which is a top to down approach. And similarly, we are in 1980s, object oriented programming languages came into play, which are an extension of procedure oriented programming language. So we'll be going through these two individually in the next tutorials, and we are having two other programming language methodologies also. We'll be going through them also. Thank you. Thanks for watching.